After 3 decades leading Melbourne's radio airwaves, Neil Mitchell will say his final goodbye to listeners this morning.
He is, of course, a very good mate of the Today Show and a good mate of ours. Neil has brought his level-headed intelligence week to week to listeners right across Victoria. And he joins us now. Neil, it's hard to believe. 33 years on air. Can you actually believe it? I can't believe it.
No level. No, I can't. It's been fun. No level-headed intelligence today. I'm dangerous. I was so excited about talking to you two. I woke up at 2:30. I've had very little sleep, and I'm always dangerous with very little sleep.
Well, you're not going to get a pressing question from us. Let me tell you. How are you feeling, my man? I mean, it's a very significant day after devoting so much of your life day to day to your show and to your listeners. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling comfortable with the decision. I'm looking forward to the future. But I'm a bit bemused by the amount of attention, quite seriously. I'm never comfortable with it. And I've done TV interviews and radio interviews and newspaper interviews. And, you know, I'm just a bloke who's got a microphone. There is nothing special about any of us. The power of us is the microphone. I'm a bit bemused by it, a bit embarrassed by it, but comfortable with what I'm doing next.
Oh, well, Neil, that is, of course, true to your character. But, I mean, I was listening to your show as I was leaving the office yesterday, streaming 3AW on my phone, and it's sort of, you've become so much a part of the fabric of Victorian and Melburnians' lives. I mean, you must appreciate that.
Yeah, and that's a great privilege. But you become that through longevity. I've been there forever, as you said. I have senior politicians ringing me saying, oh, we grew up listening to you on the school bus on the way to school, and now they won't talk to me.
What a legacy.
You've made a career of speaking to high-profile politicians, as you mentioned, celebrities, sports stars. What people don't see is how much you drive editorially. What is on your show, and I've seen that so many times and had conversations with you. Who was the one that got away for you?
Oh, I always regret Paul Keating. I mean, Paul is a brilliant political bully, and one time I was interviewing him, just before he went to air, he threatened to cut my throat, professionally, effectively.
Wow.
And we went to air and I didn't know anything about it. I was very inexperienced. These days, if he's done that, the microphone would have gone on and I would have said, what did you just say? You just threatened me. What's this about? And I would have had it out. But in those days, I said, oh, yes, Mr. Keating, yes. But he's entitled to do that.
I mean, you are the king of the first question. I mean, you just have to be, and I've been interviewed by you as well as being friends with you. I mean, it can be really awkward, the first question from you, because you just cut straight to the chase. Do you spend a lot of time on that?
Yeah, first question and the last question, some of the most important things, then you prosecute in the middle. You've got to get the audience with you. You've got to get them interested in listening. That's why I said, Carl, do you ever get sick of being a trouble magnet?
Well, clearly not. You also have this incredible, incredible gift of seeing the future.
Oh, yeah.
Do you remember this with Dan Andrews?
Well, the bet is Dan Andrews will be gone within 6 months. He's too much of a diversion for Labor. He's a trouble magnet. He's gone.
Whoa.
It was shocking then, but you were right all this time.
Yeah, I don't think he's forgiven me, though. I don't think we'll be playing... Well, we won't play golf because he's banned from every golf course in Victoria. But it turned out a bit personal with Dan in the end. I don't think we'll ever sit down and break bread.
Never all right, what are you going to do next, my man?
What am I going to do next? I have a weekly podcast, which you're both going to appear on. I'm going to do a radio spot, probably some newspaper columns, probably some television. But first, I'll have a sleep in next week.
Oh, yes. Well deserved, that's for sure.
You deserve it. You are great to listen to, and you're a great fella. And I feel privileged to know you.
And a big thank you, Neil, as well, for everything that you've done for the listeners out there and for everyone who's tuned in every morning to hear you speak. So thank you. You never quite know what you're going to say.
Thank you. No, neither do I. But, well, thank you so much to both of you for your support, because people don't realise we have a lot of contact off air where we talk about things and talk about stories and issues and exchange ideas. And that's what journalism's about.
Yeah.
And that's what I am. I'm a journalist, basically, with a microphone.
It'd be really lovely if you could cry now.
Go on. We're all watching.
Yeah, I know. Well, I thought... after getting up so early, I thought
somewhere?
I might. But...
We love you, mate.
Look,
go well.
I tell you, the danger time, 11:30, I'm throwing everybody out of the studio. It's me in the audience, nobody else. Now, that's the danger time for a tear.
Like a large part of the country will be listening.
We will be.
Go well, Neil Mitchell. We love you.
Thank you, Neil.